Today on Red Sea Insights, what makes aquarium lighting reef safe? Stay tuned to find out. Hi and welcome back to Red Sea Insights. In the previous episode, I talked about the importance of light in your reef aquarium. In this episode, I'll talk about reef-safe lighting and reef-spec. In the context of lighting, reef-spec means the tested specifications that are required by corals to flourish in an artificial environment, like your reef aquarium. So reef-spec, in a nutshell, is what your corals need. Now, if you're thinking, how does reef-safe even apply to lighting? Or what's the difference between reef-spec and reef-safe? Well, that's what I'm here for. We all know that what corals need and what reef keepers want aren't always the same thing. Sometimes what pleases the eye are the wavelengths, light intensities, or prolonged photo periods that generate excessive energy. This undesired energy source turns into heat, promotes the formation of toxic free oxygen radicals, and damages the coral's tissue, zooxanthellae, and more. That's why we created the reef-safe standard for lighting that focuses on us as reef hobbyists. It reduces the risk of user error, which may damage the corals. Red Sea's Reef LED light allows us to set and change the lighting to suit our visual preferences, but still be on safe grounds without harming the corals. To determine exactly what meets both the biological and physiological needs of these amazing creatures, we conducted intensive research into the photobiology of coral. We were able to identify the specific light spectrum, light intensity, and photo period that provide the optimal conditions for corals to flourish. These are our guidelines for creating optimal reef conditions in your aquarium, or what we like to call reef spec. Just to give you an idea, the optimal spectrum for coral growth and color expression is between 360 to 480 nanometers. We're talking about UV and blue mainly, and not all of it is within the visible light range. If you go above 480 nanometers into the greens, the yellows, and reds, you could even harm the coral. I'll explain more about it in future episodes. That's it for now. Stay tuned for our next episode. We'll take a deep dive into the light spectrum and bust some myths about how to measure it. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any questions or suggestions. Click here to watch the next video. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.